done, please follow the orange line. Process the roll of film we found in your bag, Mr. Parrish. They're not very pretty pictures. Also, you left a camera in the hotel. I processed that roll as well.
Can I see them?
It's not a courtesy, Mr. Parrish. It's evidence.
Do you guys have your own lab, or do you have to send it out?
We have a lab. Your legal aid should be here within 30 minutes or so. Now, you understand you don't have to talk to me until she gets here if you don't. You know that's all. So I can ask you one question.
Sure.
What was it about William York that upset you, sir? I mean, what did he do to provoke all of this?
Family photos depict smiling faces. Births, weddings, holidays, children's birthday parties. People take pictures of the happy moments in their lives. Someone looking through our photo album would conclude that we had led a joyous, leisurely existence, free of tragedy. No one ever takes a photograph of something they want to forget.
Sorry, kiddo, I gotta work.
Elizabeth! I'm gonna get some takeout for dinner, okay?
Okay.
See ya.
See ya.
Jake, are you coming or what?
I'm coming! There's one.
Okay. Just for a minute, I'm just dropping off some film. Make sure you can see me, okay?
Okay.
Got three emails today.
Okay. Can I get that address again?
Yes, it's
326 Serrano Terrace, Yoshi. I'll take care of Mrs. Yorkin. What have we got today?
Two rolls, and I think I've got one in here as well. And can I have two prints of each, please?
Like a mini Lux. It's a very nice camera.
Really? Because Will's been trying to get me to go digital. And I'm...
Oh, don't do that. I'd be out of a job. Oh, you have one shot left.
Oh, that's okay.
Well, it's a shame to waste it.
Oh, no, really, it's fine. Oh, no, please.
How's Jake doing?
Oh, he's great. Just had a birthday and... Oh.
See you in 40 minutes.
Thanks, sir. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, Jake.
Sliced through an exposure on that last roll, sir.
Yes, Yoshi, I know. I made a mistake. Mrs. Levitt has a problem. Offer her a free roll of film.
All right.
I've been doing POS mini lab work for over 20 years now. consider it an important job. When people's houses are on fire, what's the first thing they save after their pets and their loved ones are safe? The family photos. Some people think that this is a job for a clerk. They actually believe that any idiot that attends a two-day seminar can master the art of making beautiful prints in less than an hour. But of course, like most things, there's far more to it than meets the eye. I've seen the prints they fob off on people at the Rexall of Fotech. Milky, washed out prints. Too dark prints. There's no sense of reverence for the service they're providing for people. I process these photos as if they were my own.
See, someone had quite a birthday party. I did them 5x7 for you.
Oh, and one of them 4x6.
The larger ones are better. I didn't charge you extra for it.
Okay, it's okay, I guess. How much do I lose?
Oh, 30.06. But let's just call it an even 30.
Thanks.
You know, we have a special gift for birthday boys.
Really?
Mm-hmm, that's right. Birthday boys get a free camera.
Wow. Jake, what do you say? Thanks.
You're welcome, buddy.
We're taking Jake to Six Flags this weekend, so I'll see you very soon.
See you.
Bye.
See you, Jake.
Whoa, what a cool camera, huh?
Yeah.
This is a great shot.
Nice.
Oh, you guys are so cute.
Oh, this is
so sweet. Okay, this one's going into the trash.
Oh, yeah.
Look at your face. That's classic.
Well, I need that back.
No, you're not getting it back.
Nope. Don't give her it.
Well, I'm serious.
Don't give her it.
Don't. Nope.
She's serious. She's serious. Hey.
Told you.
Hey, how'd this one get in here?
Oh, that's Sai.
Sai?
Sai the photo guy.
Oh, yeah. Sai took it to finish off the roll.
Great. Well, now we have a picture of Sai, the photo guy.
All right, guys. It's so past your bedtime.
Anything else, Sai?
Oh, thanks. Just the check's fine.
What you got there? Family photos?
Yeah.
Yeah, you mind if I take a look?
for someone.
Somebody at school?
No.
What do you mean you feel bad?
Someone seems sad. They don't have any friends. People make fun of them. It makes me feel bad for them.
Who is that and doesn't have any friends?
Sigh.
Sigh? The photo guy at the 1 hour place?
Yeah.
Jake.
I really feel bad for him.
But Jake, we don't know that Sai is sad. I mean, we really don't know that much about him, you know? I mean, he might even have a lot of friends. He probably has a girlfriend and a mommy and a daddy who love him.
He does.
So sweet of you to think of somebody else like that, you know? Listen, Jake. Not everybody is as lucky as we are, you know? But maybe, if we send them good thoughts, it'll make them feel better. So why don't we close our eyes and send Sai some good thoughts?
Okay.
Next time we see Sai, he won't seem so sad.
Okay. You have to go to sleep, Poopy.
Okay. I love you.
Good
night. How do you think we pay for all this? I'm just asking you. What do you think, there's a money fairy that comes and slips an envelope under my pillow every month?
What are you even talking about?
Well, how? All of this stuff, the new Mercedes, the matching washer and dryer, the fucking chill Sandra boss you have on, now how? I love you, Nate, I do. But if you continually want our life to look like something out of a magazine, I'm sorry, I've got to work to make that happen.
Do you even believe what you're saying? Huh? This is not about things, Will. And it's not about money. You're neglectful. Do you understand that?
What?
You're an emotionally neglectful husband. And you're an emotionally neglectful father.
Fucking neglectful?
You're not here, Will. You're not here. You're never here.
Thank you.
Sunday is our busiest day. People tend to shoot most of their pictures on weekends. The store has several regular customers. There's Mrs. Von Unworth, who only takes pictures of her cats. I've never seen a picture of a human being. Just cats.
Two copies, please, Mr. Parrish.
There's Mr. Siskin. Mr. Siskin is an insurance claims adjuster. He only brings in pictures of wrecked cars.
The usual sigh, I need these by 3.
We get all the new parents, which in this neighborhood makes up a big part of our business. New parents go photo crazy.
I don't know how many rolls I have here.
Cindy, a nurse from a nearby cosmetic surgery clinic, is a regular customer. We do all of Dr. Freed's before and after shots.
Oh, thanks, sir.
Then, there's the amateur porn artists. We have to report kitty porn and animal cruelty, but anything else, no questions asked.
How many prints do you need of these?
Just one set.
Sire, are you kidding me?
What?
I got 3 of these fucking machines down today. I'll be in Heber Springs by 3.
Larry, all I'm asking you to do is look at these prints.
Plus 0.3. Sire, are you fucking kidding me? 0.3? Nobody gives a shit until those shifts are in the double digits.
It's blue, Larry. Well, I'll bet Brad cares about a plus 0.3.
Are you fucking threatening me? Breaking my balls over a plus 3 blue shift. Fucking asshole. Next time you call me out here, that thing better be belching fire.
That's a great attitude, Larry. Thanks for your precision work.
Sai,
what the hell are you doing?
Excuse me. What was the deal with you and the AGFA guy?
Well, Bill, I'm trying to preserve a minimum level of quality for my customers.
Your customers.
And he seems to think that a plus 0.3 shift to cyan is insignificant. It's massive.
Sai, let me try and explain something to you one more time. You need to take another look at your place on the food chain. These aren't your customers. They're Save Mart's customers. If you haven't noticed, this isn't Neiman Marcus. People just want to come in here with their kids, have a good time, and save a few pennies on paper towels and socks. If they wanted to see yelling and screaming, they stay at home.
It was wrong of me to create a scene in front of all those customers, Bill. It won't happen again.
Excuse me. I need some help here. I'm trying to figure out if this will work with my mat.
I'm sorry. This isn't my section. You're Will Yorkin.
Yeah?
Cy Parrish. I'm the photo tech here. I do all your family's pictures.
Oh, right. Cy the photo guy.
Right. Here you are in the flesh. Oh, it's just that I don't see you in here too often.
Nina usually does most of the shopping. Can you help me with this?
Well, wish I could, but this is computers, and I do photo finishing. It's not my section.
You know, I'm actually in just a little bit of a rush. I had one question I needed answered.
Oh, no problem. I'll get the hook. Customer needs immediate assistance, aisle 4. Customer assistance, aisle 4. So it'll be here in just a minute.
Great, thanks.
You got it. So is the rest of the family here?
Jake's around here somewhere.
Very lucky man, Mr.
my saying so, a very beautiful house, too.
Thank you, Sai. I appreciate that. But I really need to get all this stuff and get the hell out of here.
Hey, I understand.
Hey, thanks for all your help.
Oh, it's okay. You say hello for me.
It will do.
Well, I gotta be getting back. There'll be someone here, and just, there you go.
Oh, great. You know, it doesn't say here if this will work for my Mac.
But no, this is PC only. We have some Mac-based stuff now.
Oh! Jake!
Huh?
I was just talking to your dad. What do you have there?
Evangelion.
Neon Genesis Evangelion. Wow. What does he do?
Well, he's a good guy, he can fly, and he has a silver sword that can kill bad guys.
Really?
Yeah. He's 60 feet tall.
And you really want this, don't
you? Yeah.
Wow.
Jake! Come on. No more toys, we're leaving.
Gotta go.
This back for you, okay?
Thanks. See ya.
See you later. I'm sure my customers never think about it, but these snapshots are their little stands against the flow of time. The shutter's clicked, the flash goes off, and they've stopped time, just for the blink of an eye. These pictures have anything important to say to future generations, it's this. I was here. I existed. I was young. I was happy, and someone cared enough about me in this world to take my picture. How much for this one? Most people don't take snapshots of the little things. The used Band-Aid. The guy at the gas station. The wasp on the jello. But these are the things that make up the true picture of our lives. People don't take pictures of these things. Told you 1,000 times. Jazz? It's a good game. How many prints would you like of these?
Just one set.
Maya, that's a very beautiful name.
Thank you.
Have you ever picked up prints here before?
I think maybe once. It was a long time ago.
Face looks very familiar. You work around here?
Sort of near here.
Probably seen you around the mall.
I've been here pretty often.
Well, we're a little backed up today. Is 6 o'clock okay?
I probably won't be able to pick them up till tomorrow or the next day.
See you then.
Come on, little hustle, little hustle. Here we go. Right there. Come on. Good shot. That's the way to strike the ball. You gotta get in front of us, son.
Jake, I want you to drill it, all right? Visualize where you want the ball to go and drill it.
Jake, that's not good enough. We have to work on that. All right? All right. Pay attention, fellas. A little focus. Drill it in there, man. Come on. Good shot. Good shot. Next practice Thursday. Can't make it. Be sure and tell Derek.
Hey, Jake.
No, oh, you forgot your sweatshirt.
I was just on my way home from work. I saw you out there. I thought I'd check it out.
Jake, you all right?
Yeah.
Mom picking you up?
Hey, I got my bike.
It's a great shot you made. Your coach was a little rough. I thought he should be more supportive. You want me to have a word with him for you?
Yeah, it's okay.
I will.
Thanks.
Okay. When I was your age, I wasn't very good at sports. Yeah. I was kind of chubby kid. Let's face it, I was fat. Sick all the time. Kept coming down with mono and hepatitis. And I broke my collarbone and I had to wear this weird cast where I kept my arm up like this all winter. Exactly the most popular kid.
How'd you break your collarbone?
Oh, fell out of a tree. How's your dad doing?
Good.
Does he come to see the games?
Yeah, sometimes.
Does he come to see any of the games?
He's really busy at work. I don't know, he's busy all the time.
Sounds like an important guy.
I guess he owns a company and everything.
Probably just wants to make sure that... It's the one you wanted.
Mr. Parrish, I can't take this.
Sure you can, Jake.
My parents wouldn't let me. I better be getting back home now.
Sure?
Yeah, thanks anyway, Mr. Parrish.
Okay, see you around the store.
Okay.
Hey, Jake. The name's Cy.
Okay, Cy.
some kind of shift. I don't know. A couple of weeks? Maybe 5 weeks. 6. No, I know that, but... yeah, but this feels different, you know? Listen, Jen, I can't talk right now. I'll call you back this afternoon. Hi, Si.
Hi there. I was just at the Dairy Queen. I saw you down here and thought I'd say hello.
I'm just grabbing some shopping fuel.
I never see you away from the store. After all these years, you'd think we'd run into each other at some point.
Why, do you live around here?
I live downtown.
Oh. Well, that's quite a drive.
No, I'm used to it. You have a nice boy there.
Oh, Jake. Yeah. A little sensitive, maybe, but he likes you, Si. He calls you Si the photo guy.
I've watched him grow since he was this big.
That's right. We've been doing our pictures for a long time.
You know, I almost feel like Uncle Si.
Well, I've got some serious shopping to do, Si.
Oh, sure. Take care.
So weird. I'm reading that exact book right now.
You're kidding.
No. I can't believe that you'd be reading that book.
I know he writes a lot about noticing coincidence, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
That thing he says about fear? The things we fear the most have already happened to us.
Wow. I had no idea you were such a deep thinker, Si.
I wouldn't say that.
Do you have any children, Si?
Me? No, I'm not married.
No girlfriend?
No. I have a snapshot of my mother, though.
Looks very nice.
She's passed away.
Oh. I'm sorry, Si. Gosh, you know, I have to go. It was really nice chatting with you.
It was nice chatting with you.
I'll probably see you very soon. We can't seem to go a day without taking a picture of something, so.
Lucky for us.
Okay. Bye, Si.
Bye.
What's with the get-up, Si?
It's Wednesday, Bill. I was doing the SRS.
Si, there's been some discrepancies in the click, huh?
That's probably Yoshi. You know, his math skills are pretty weak, but I told you about that when you moved him over from audio.
Now, all the discrepancies are around the laws that you initial.
They are? Yeah. Oh, you know, I guess sometimes at the end of the week, you get a little tired.
We're not talking about a few innocent math errors, Si. The net clicks all zero out. They always zero out. The problem is, Si, that the shutdown clicks don't correspond at all. I mean, they don't even come close to matching the amount of prints that we see.
Well, then it's probably a problem with the reorder counter.
Well, I asked Larry about that.
What did he say?
Looked at the counter and said that he checked out. He also said that in 14 years of servicing, he's never seen a faulty counter on an Agfa unit.
Really?
So the question is, Cy, where did all those unaccounted for prints go?
Well, what kind of discrepancy are we talking about, Bill?
We're talking about hundreds of prints, Cy.
That's not possible, Bill.
Oh, no, I've done the math. And the POs confirm it, too.
Well, I don't know anything about it.
Well, I think you do, Cy.
Well, I don't, Bill.
Look, Cy, I've got a family. I'm not losing my job over this. I'm letting you go.
No.
These log discrepancies would be enough, but you've been spacing out on the job, taking 90-minute lunch breaks, creating scenes in front of the customers, giving away free merchandise, free disposable cameras to customers on their birthday. That must have been your bright idea. Sure shit isn't company policy.
You can't do this.
It's done, Cy. I talked to Sims at District. Now, you finish out the week and clear out your locker. And if you do something like fuck up today's prints on...
I haven't fucked up a customer's prints in 11 years.
Just get back out there.
Cy? Jake wanted to get his birthday gift processed.
I'm sorry?
At the camera?
Right. The birthday gift. Number of sets?
Oh, just one is fine.
4x6, 5x7.
The ones we usually get.
Standard.
Jake had a really great time with the camera, didn't you, Jake?
Yeah. What was that address again?
It's 326 Serrano Terrace. Say, are you all right?
I'm fine. I'll have these for you tomorrow.
Bye. Bye.
guess I...
I won't be coming back, Yoshi. Bill let me go.
You were fired?
Yep.
Really?
Really.
Wow.
I really enjoyed working with you, Yoshi.
Yeah, me too, Sai. Sai? Sai, I just wanted to, Well, I guess I just wanted to say thank you, you know?
For what?
For teaching me all this stuff.
You're welcome, Yoshi. Don't let the place go downhill, okay?
I won't, Sai.
security for all, or no one is secure. It is no concern of ours how you run your own planet. But if you threaten to extend your violence, this Earth of yours will be reduced to a burned-out cinder. Now, we do not pretend to have achieved perfection, but we do have a system, and it works. Your choice is simple. Join us and live in peace, or pursue your present course and face obliteration. We shall be waiting for your answer. The decision rests with you.
Oxford English Dictionary. The word snapshot was first used in 1808 by an English sportsman by the name of Sir Andrew Hawker. He noted in his diary that almost every bird he shot that day was taken by snapshot, meaning a hurried shot, taken without deliberate aim. Snapshot, then, was originally a hunting term.
Dropping off some film. Just a customer. I can still shop here, can't I, Bill?
No, Si, you can't still shop here.
No, I believe I can, Bill.
Shh.
There's no law that says I can't shop here just because I was fired.
I checked it out, Si. There's 1,000 other places you could do your photos. There's no reason to come all the way down here other than to fuck with me.
It's a very good reason. I calibrated that machine personally. It's the best mini lab in the state.
To do your film. I do not want you back in here.
Thanks, Bill.
What is it, Yoshi? You can't just leave your station unmanned down there.
I think you need to see these, sir.
Yeah, what do you got there? Is it the anal sex fiend again?
Hey,
would you say Mr. Parrish's demeanor was when he came in?
Demeanor?
Yeah. How did he seem? Did he seem upset or agitated in any way?
I don't know. He seemed fine.
Cy and I had some words when he came into the store. Under the circumstances, I was surprised to see him, and I asked him what he was doing here. And I suggested in strong language that in the future, he bring his picture somewhere.
Yoshi, I'm going to need to make some Xerox copies of this. Can you show me where I can get that done?
Yeah.
Mr. Owens, why don't you come and grab a seat and try to calm down? Your wife and child, they're somewhere safe then? Officers on standby inside the store now. Now look, he may come back and pick up his photos. He may not. It's hard to say. I doubt he will.
You really think that's a good idea? I mean, this place is wall-to-wall families.
If he's stupid enough to come back here, he'll never make it inside the store.
Are you insane?
Mr. Parrish, this is the police. They're in the apartment. We need to know right now.
Can you explain this? He must be programmed for courage.
Mr. Parrish!
It's clear.
Officer Lyon, 66321.
Go ahead, 321.
I need to be patched through to Bander Z and TMU. Right away, please.
321, that's
10-4. Hey, Dan, take a look at this.
What do you got? Y-O-R-K-I-N.
I'm sorry, sir, I don't find that name registered.
Can you try a Maya Burson? B-U-R-S-O-N. Thank you.
Hello?
Hello, this is room service. I'm sorry to bother you, but we have your order all ready to go here. We just needed to know if you'd like coffee with that.
We'll do a coffee. No, just a drink.
And this is for room 217.
No, we're 511, right? We're
511. 511? Oh my gosh. I must be looking at the wrong thing here. I'm sorry, we'll have it right up to you in just a minute. Room service, please.
One moment, please.
Room service, this is John. May I take your order, please?
Hello, John. This is Will Yorkin in 511. We've decided to go out for lunch. I was wondering if it's okay to cancel our order.
No problem. That was 511, right?
That's right, John. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, Mr. Yorkin.
Yes?
You know Yorkin?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Detective Van Der Zee of the Evans County Threat Management Unit. This is Detective Autobridge.
Threat management? Is Jake all right?
No, everyone's fine. We need to speak with your husband, William.
Will's at work. What's this about?
You mind if we come in for a minute?
No, sure.
How can I help you, sir?
Hi. I need a room, but not too high a floor.
Check, sir? Yes, we can offer you 313.
Anything on 5?
I'll check, sir.
Will Yorkin's office?
Dwayne, this is Nina. I need to talk to Will right now.
He's not in, Miss Yorkin, but I could have him return as soon as he gets back.
Dwayne, I need you to get him on the phone immediately. This is an emergency.
Okay, I'll try him right now. I'm going to put you on hold.
No, Dwayne. He's trying him right
now. Where's your son, Mrs. Joachim?
He's at his friend Eric's house.
It might be a good idea to have Eric's mother drive him home now.
My God.
I'm afraid you have to sign for this.
Second.
You get on the bed. Get on the goddamn bed. Look, I've got plenty of cash in my pants, in the wallet, in the
bathroom.
Shut up. Close the drapes.
Close them!
Who told you to do that?
Close the drapes.
Did I tell you to wrap a towel around yourself?
No.
Let me explain what's going on here. I tell you to do things, then you fucking do them. Exactly like I tell you. I'm going to tell you this one time, and one time only. You got the picture?
Yeah.
Do you understand me?
Yes.
Good. I'll get on the bed. Talking to a brick wall. Did I tell you to touch her?
No.
I don't want you to touch her. If you touch her again, I stab you in the heart.
Can you ring the room once more, please?
I'll try it one more time.
Now, Missy, I have to take the rope off. What's this? Can't you stop your sniffling? This is supposed to look like fun.
No touching. Smile.
You have to look like you're having fun. It's a game.
Doing it!
Stop yelling at me.
I'm not doing it right. Like this.
Detective Vanders, this is Detective Otterbridge. We just spoke on the phone.
Right, so what is all this about?
Any word from Miss Person's room yet?
No.
This is the police. Will you open the door, please?
James.
It was Von York.
Person?
Thank you.
person?
You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent, anything you say can and will be used against you.
Outerbridge.
If we have to speak with an attorney and have the attorney present during questioning, if you so desire and cannot afford one, an attorney will be able to.
Are you married, Detective? You have any children?
I'll be the one asking the questions here, sir.
No, just one question. Detective, are you a family man?
That's none of your business, sir.
So you're right, it isn't. It is none of my business. But I'm guessing by your answer and that ring on your finger that you are. That makes you a very fortunate man. I can also tell by the way that you've treated me so far and the way you carry out your job. You're a good man. A good husband. Father, a man who appreciates his good fortune. You're not the type of father who'd cheat on his wife. Hurt his family. Betray their trust. You would never neglect and abuse your children. Make horrible demands of your children. You would never ask. You would never ask your children to do things. Things that children shouldn't do. You would never take disgusting, sick, degrading pictures of your children doing these things. You would never treat your children like animals. York and had it all, and he threw it all away.
quá muộn cho sự sám hối nơi con. Tội lỗi đã mang đi lời dạy của mẹ. Giờ đây con muốn trở lại với vòng tay khô cạn, mà ngày bên mẹ con chẳng bận tâm. Mẹ nâng con dậy, bước con đi mẹ dõi theo từng nhịp tim đập nhanh hay chậm, mà con vô tâm vô nghĩa. Một bước tay.
If I cannot have you and I will go, I want to have your love and I want to kiss you hard. One day you go away, one day I miss you so much. When you came to me, you say you love me. When you tend to go, you make up the story. The broken heart you brought to my life, the bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came? And why did you give me? We've been together too long enough. I know your soul as I know myself. You fool with me to date other guys. I know that you don't really love me. I just forgive and try to forget. Don't you really? Our faith has